pardon my taking a sip of water, but I have found that it is a good idea to hydrate before you speak. Praise God. I want to thank you for dropping whatever you were doing to come in and get this word. I want to tell you, I am very aware that I have been in front of you now, and this will be the third day in a row. Amen. I'm very aware that the Lord gave me a prophetic word that had to be released very early on Saturday morning, so I was all up in your face on Saturday. I'm very well aware, praise God, that we had relevant church on yesterday, so I was in your house on Sunday or wherever you were, and now here we are again on a Monday. But how many know, and if you've read the Bible, you do, that when the Lord has ordained a thing, when he has spoken a thing, when he is doing a thing, when he wants to get the point across, when he really wants to make sure that you get it so that you can get it, catch that. When God really wants to make sure that you get what he is saying so that you can get your portion, so that you can lay hold of what he has cued in the wings. Please catch that as well. It's a beautiful visual. What the Lord has cued in the wings, it is right there. It's ready to release into your life. Then he will say something over and over and over again. And you know what? Listen, my man, the prophet Jeremiah, he knew how that was. God will, you know, he had him say the same thing over and over. And I've actually had people, and I'm just talking a little bit, allowing the room to fill up, but I've actually had people say, well, why are you repeating this right now? You just said that the other day. You just said that last week. Well, listen, because God wants to make sure that you get it. And I'll tell you something, in the Bible, when a prophet repeat something and the message comes across over and over repetitively, God is really making a point. Praise God. A lot of people are saying that it is frozen and that you can't connect. What I want to suggest you do is go out and come back in. I am in an area that has spotty reception, but this word could not wait. But if you are having trouble connecting, go out and come back in. Let me just see who's here. Say hello. Tell me where you are tuning in from so I could say hello to you. Praise God. All right, we're not going to tolerate any foolishness on this broadcast. We're not going to tolerate it. We are going to bind every foul spirit that would have the audacity and the stupidity of mind to try to interfere with a prophetic word that has come from the Lord. We bind that foul spirit of interference and distraction in the name of Jesus Christ. And by the authority of the blood of Jesus Christ, let every demonic assignment over this word and over the manifestation of it in your life be arrested and canceled right now in the name of Jesus. No patience, no tolerance, zero in Jesus' name. I really think that some people think I'm nicer than I am. But anyway, if you've been with me for a while, you remember the early days, praise God. All right, to the person who said, do you have a word for me? Yes, I do. You've got to stay tuned. This word is going to be for you. It really is. So hello in North Carolina. God bless you. We are going to be in North Carolina very shortly. Hello in Philadelphia. I love Philly. Irvine, California. Hello, hello. Lynchburg, Virginia. It is wonderful to have you in the house. There is a young lady, Sacramento, California. There is a young lady, Gabriella M. Your last name begins with an M. I'm not going to say what it is, to protect your privacy, but you had a birthday on yesterday, and the Holy Spirit has just put it in my spirit to say happy birthday to you. Listen, I know that it was your birthday yesterday, but listen, it's your birthday all month, woman of God, and you need to claim that in the name of Jesus, because God has not finished blessing you in the month of March 2019. In fact, I prophesy in the name of Jesus, Miss Gabriella, that you are going to receive touches from God, an influx of favor of the Lord in your life for the remainder of March 2019. I'm not saying he's going to be done in March, but I'm saying that he's going to turn up the heat and turn up the volume in your birthday month, and you need to receive that in the name of Jesus. And I hear by the Spirit of God that you have a very topsy-turvy relationship with family members, a lot of dysfunction in your family. I I hear you, Holy Spirit. A lot of dysfunction in the family, even some bizarre jealousy from towards you, from people who they are the ones who, my God, if anybody should love you and unconditionally and support you, it should be that. Is it your mom, sweetheart? Is it a sister? It's a female in your family. It feels very motherly to me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. But God said, listen, he's going to make it up to you in spades. He's going to make it up to you. It's going to be all aces for you. Don't mourn what you don't have. You can't ask somebody to give you what they don't have to give. You can't expect somebody to give you something they don't have to give. She does not have it in her possession. She does not have that in her capacity. You may have heard me talk about my own dysfunctional relationship with my mom, all my life. And now, of course, she's passed away. Both my parents are gone. And I'm an only child. That's why y'all are really my family, okay? It's not a catchphrase for me. It's real. But a very bizarre relationship. And now that she's passed away, this is not our word, but hang with me here for another 2 seconds. This is not our word, but now that my mom has passed away, I fully understand, and it's only by the grace of God, that my mother really did the best she could. She was working with a whole basket of broken pieces, and those broken pieces were her life. She loved the Lord, then she got involved in the occult and got demonized, and then right toward the end of her life, when she, right before she died, mommy started making her way back to Jesus. And I could cry about that, because I give the Lord so much glory for that he pulled her back and he reminded her who she really was. But this is not about me, it's about you, Miss G. Gabriella. But see, you and I have that connection and that experience, and the Lord wants me to tell you, please stop being heartbroken and disappointed because she doesn't give you what you know she should and what you believe she could. Now, I'm not saying you're wrong, you're right. You're right, and you will do it differently in your relationships. You will do it differently. But see, when you're dealing with somebody who's got nothing but a basket of broken pieces, and the Lord has not made them whole. See, she's fragmented. God has not. She's not nearly as healed or wise as she thinks she is. So you got to pray for her. And I know that's backwards. I know it's twisted. It should be the other way around. But you never know. See, your mom. I feel like this is your mom. She is still living. God can do a miracle in her life, and this whole thing can still turn around for you. So just continue to pray for her. Amen. But also, you need to get ready, because God is going to continue sending into your life what you need. And you have a mother figure coming forth, and you have brothers and sisters in the Lord coming forth, and you're going to have the exceedingly abundantly. Happy birthday. Isn't that wild? John's over here driving. Isn't that wild? I came on here to drop a prophetic word that the Lord, and it's gonna be a good one too. But the Lord just really arrested my spirit because he needed to speak to his daughter. We serve the God who will leave the 99 to come and talk to the one. We serve the God who will leave the 99 and come and get the one. Hallelujah. They're saying hello to you, John. Can you say hello?
Hello.
Can you say hello again?
Yes, hello.
You gotta speak up, baby. We're on the road. Okay, he said, I know I'm driving. Amen. Praise God. Well, all right, everybody. All right, now they said drive, John. Oh, he is driving because we have to get to an appointment, which I think I have like, oh God, I've got only maybe 15 minutes here. We gotta do this quickly. Please share this. If you have not already done so, swipe right on an iPhone, swipe up on an Android device. If you have one of the newer phones, you've got the three little buttons at the bottom. You can work your buttons. Come on, work your buttons, baby. Work it. Come on, you gotta work your buttons. W-E-R-K-K. Work. That's how we say it in New York. W-E-R-K-K. Work your buttons. Amen. Work them for Jesus. And we're gonna share on whatever platform the Lord leads you to while I get my sunglasses out because it's bright. Hold on. Sorry, I don't really want to do this, but somebody said work. Amen. I don't really want to do this, but I need to have, I need to be able to see properly. All right, so let's go ahead and get into this word. Father, I thank you for your spirit. I thank you for the unction clearly coming forth, God, to release this word. Lord, I thank you, Father, for all the blessings that are going to come about in the lives of your people as a result of this word. God, I thank you that your Holy Spirit is drawing people to get this word right now, oh God. I thank you that their hearts are open to receive, oh Lord. I prophesy a good measure is going to be released into the hearts and minds and the very lives of your people, Lord. And you are going to get all the glory, God, while they receive the blessing. Father, we love you and we exalt your name in the mighty and forever matchless name of Jesus Christ. Let every interference be bound by the authority of Jesus Christ, and let this word go forth exceedingly abundantly, God, to bring you glory and to be a blessing to your people. I love you and praise you in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. I'm going to give you very quickly, it's really a twofold key to explosive financial overflow. I don't know if you caught the word on Saturday morning, but we are under an anointing for overflow in your life. If you are one who has been believing for overflow, please bless yourself. Go get the word and let it minister to you. Open your heart. Let the Holy Ghost talk to you. Then you want to go and you want to listen to Relevant Church on yesterday, because the Lord has shown us what happens when you are in a personal prophetic season. The things that you have access to, the favor and the resources you have access to. You can pray for any of those things to be released into your life. Now, you've got to be in position. You have to be in position. What does that mean? That means that overflow, it's a contingency, sweetheart. And I know a lot of pastors don't preach this. And that's why those type of pastors will never have a real prophet come to their church. Because we will tell you the truth. And the truth is, mercy is 100% free. Salvation is 100% free. But if you want to access riches and glory through Christ Jesus, Philippians 4:19, if you want to access the treasury of heaven and have an open heaven, a window of heaven open over you, Malachi 3:10, then there's protocols that must be followed to access it. I'm going to give you a twofold key, a twofold protocol that if you work it, I don't know if this is spam or not, we'll find out. If you work this, you will begin to access financial overflow. Let me give this to you quickly because we don't have a lot of time. The first one is the Luke 6:38 principle, which we mention all the time, and I believe God has me mention it frequently because not enough people are. You know, they just call out these prophetic words, they call out these things, and they post these things that sound good, and they get the people hype, but they don't tell them how to access it. They don't tell them what they have to do to get into position. You know, the Bible says in Isaiah 1:19 that you will eat the good of the land. And that means that you will have a full pantry. You will have victory. You will have prosperity. Come on, you will have success. But if you are willing and obedient, and you don't hear people talking about that as much as we need to, because everybody is willing to have that, but you got to be obedient. Well, I'm going to give you two keys that are going to allow you to unlock massive financial overflow, explosive financial overflow. The first one is the Luke 6:38 principle. Start giving to other people. Just start doing it. Look for somebody to bless. Look for someone. If you're here right now and you're saying, that's just it, Prophet JoLynne, I don't have anything to give. I am in a really hard place. I have nothing. Here's my response, and I'm going to be incredibly transparent with you. I know what you're talking about. I have been there. Just 7 years ago, I had so little money that I would sometimes cut back on what I ate all week long. Please catch this. I, I, I beg you in the name of Jesus, hear the word of the Lord on today. I would sometimes go eat very sparingly all week long, just so that I could have enough food to have friends over on a Sunday after church. This was in the days when I was living alone out at that broken down lake house, and the Lord was dealing with me, and he was shifting me, and he was preparing me for inheritance. Catch it. He was preparing me for activation and inheritance. I had no idea that my husband was very close and being prepared for me. I had no idea that my anointing was about to increase and God was going to reveal to me the real purpose for what this gift was that I have, what it really is, what it really can do. Come on, what does that thing do? And what it really is here for and how it's to be used to serve the body of Christ. I had no idea. Now, somebody said, pray for others. Yes, we should always pray for others. God bless you. That's not what I'm talking about. You must find a way to bless other people physically. In those days, I would cut back what I ate all week long just so I could have people over after church on a Sunday. Now, granted, it was a simple meal. It was very often just homemade pasta sauce. You know, I'm half Italian. I make pasta, homemade sauce, and a big salad. You know, buy a loaf of bread, bread and butter, salad, pasta, simple. I couldn't really do meat. Every once in a while, maybe there might be chicken, but you know, it was all I could do. But you have to understand, God looks at the heart. He saw my disposition. He saw my heart, and he understood that he was working with a giver. And God will give seed to the sower. The minute he knows that you are a giver, the minute he knows that you are a sower, the minute he knows he's got somebody he can work with, he will start giving seed to you. Now, the Luke 6, are we there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. The Luke 6, can you text him?
Not right now.
Okay. The Luke 6 and 38 principle is very, very clear. And we all like to say, oh yes, it's going to be a good measure. Press down, shaking together. Ooh, running over, overflow. Get ready, get ready, get ready. And we love that part, but we skip the part that clearly says God's going to use the same measure to give to you. Whatever your measure is for overflow, the same measure, the same measuring cup that you use to give to other people is what God is going to use to give to you. And you would say, but that's just it. I'm trying to tell you I have nothing. And I'm trying to tell you, baby, I had nothing too. But you find a way. Hear me. If you want to break out of this, if you want to access this financial principle and financial overflow, you find a way. Eat for me. I didn't eat so much during the week. The benefit was, the benefit was I fit in my clothes. I'm just going to say it. Hate if you want to. But on Sunday after church, people knew, everybody knew. It became a thing. They would come back to JoLynne's Lake House because it was going to be dinner. It might be a modest dinner, but it was going to be with love. And we all love the Lord. And people would come over. Amen. You find a way to give to other people. I'm going to show you something that will allow you to access overflow, that will allow you to access outpouring, and God will begin to give seed to you because he knows that you sow. Amen. Now, okay, how do I want to transition into this? Because this is all right. There is a level of financial overflow that is reserved for people who are willing to do radical things, borderline a little crazy. Please hear me. Please. There is a level of overflow that is reserved for the people who are just a little crazy. Crazy. God knows that you're radical enough that you'll do it. You're radical enough that come on, he walked you through some seasons. Come on, he knows that you've been through the fire. He knows that you've been through hell. And now you're saved. You're sanctified. But, you know, where you've been and what you've lived through has definitely made you a little, you know, come on, you got some Elijah in you. You'll go up to Mount Carmel. You'll drop kick a man right to the throat. You know, you got a little crazy left. And you, what, is this him? He's here. Oh, our appointment's here. You will do it. Just tell him 5 minutes. Four minutes. All right. I'm going to give you a very quick example. And I feel the anointing of the Lord, this is very powerful. This is going to help somebody. My husband and I are in, don't go in without me, please.
What?
My husband and I are in West Palm Beach last Sunday. All right. We flew out last Monday morning, but it was a Sunday afternoon. Or I'm sorry, it was a Sunday morning, last Sunday. And after prayer, I heard the Lord tell me to text somebody and ask them if they had anybody to give them a baby shower. Now, listen to me. This person, I will not say the name because I'm going to respect them and respect their privacy. It is a pastor's wife. Their ministry is a very prominent ministry. This is an established minister, okay? Couple, family. Been in ministry a very long time. Comes from a family of ministry. But I heard the Lord tell me very clearly, text that woman and she's pregnant. Ask her if she has anybody to give her a baby shower. Because you need to do for somebody what you did not have somebody to do for you. You had no one to do this for you. I need you to do for her what no one did for you. Now, pause. It made no sense because these are people, they're not like me. They have family. They're not like me and John. Okay, they've got a big family. Well, John's got a big family. I have no family. You guys are my family and John is my family. But she's got siblings, he's got siblings. They both have parents that are living. Didn't make any sense whatsoever. But I had to be obedient to the Lord. Because I have learned that God will give assignments to the people he knows are crazy enough to obey. Hear me. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare radical obedience will release radical blessing in your life. Radically sowing into somebody's life will release radical explosive financial overflow into your life. So I text her. And it's kind of like, LOL, woman of God, I'm sure this is kind of funny. Oh, LOL, I'm sure it's kind of crazy. But, in prayer, I heard the Lord say, just to ask you if you have anybody to give you a baby shower. Ha, 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 I'm sure you do. But I had to be obedient. This woman of God responds to me, and she said, I'm just going to paraphrase. She said, my mind is blown. I don't even know what to say. No, I do not. I do not have anyone to give me a shower. I'm on certain terms with family members. I don't talk to them. My best friend lives in another state. I'm not on good terms with so-so, you know. I didn't have a baby shower with my first baby. Wasn't planning on one for this one. I said, well, apparently you better plan on it because I'm coming. And I know y'all live in Florida and I live in New York. Don't matter to me. God said, do it. I'm your Huckleberry. I'm your girl. And I told her, remember, Jen? I said, I will come there. I am coming there and we're going to do this right. And you know I don't do anything small and it's going to be probably a little too fancy. Okay, and it's going to be way too cuteness overload, but I'm going to give you a shower that's going to make the devil mad. I'm coming. When you hear in your spirit the Lord tell you to inquire after something or to do something for somebody, please, in the name of Jesus, open your heart and hear me on today. Do not interact with it. What do I mean by that? Don't start saying, well, I don't know. I don't really know. I don't really see it. Is that smart? Is that, you know, they probably don't need that. They probably don't want that. God does not need your conversation or contemplation. God needs your obedience, and he's trying to do something for you. He's trying to do something for you. Now, I want to point something out. For anybody who is familiar with the shoes on the altar story, how last month I'm sitting in a church in Florida and the Lord tells me to put my only good shoes on the altar. And I'd only worn them 5 times, right? And then I'm in West Palm Beach last weekend and I get gifted with so much beautiful stuff from the same designer that we had to literally go buy a suitcase to bring it home. That happened after I reached out to that pastor's wife and committed to doing the shower for her. See, that's the part of the story he didn't hear. But it was time to tell it now. I believe, and I'm prophesying to you right now in the name of Jesus, and this is not all that I have. I had more. I'm going to save it for coffee chat, okay? We will not forget this. It's in my notes. I got my date with destiny journal. And if you don't have your date with destiny journal and mug, why not? You need to go get it and get the book. And we send you a beautiful pen as well. But I'll save this for Friday coffee chat. But I need you to open up and receive this in the name of Jesus. I am prophesying to you right now in the mighty and forever matchless name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. God wants to release financial overflow into your life. He wants to release explosive financial overflow. But you need to hear me. That Luke 6:38 principle, it's not just money. It's going to also be stuff. It's going to also be stuff. Now, the Lord will use, I don't have time to go into it the way I want to, but the Lord will use people to bless you and to just pour out to you. And it will be specific to who you are and what you need. God knows who you are. He knows the desires of your heart. Psalm 37:4, He wants to give you the desires of your heart. And I am prophesying to you in the name of Jesus Christ that in this season, it's going to come forth quickly for many of you. God wants to bring you into financial overflow, explosive financial overflow. He wants to pour out a good measure to you, and not a measly one, but a mega one. Are you hearing me? A mega measure, pressed down, shaken together, really running over. But He's going to test you. He's going to test you. He's going to see if you will sow into someone else. He's going to see if you will radically obey Him and do something like me, texting this pastor's wife. No way did I think that this woman had nobody to give her a shower. She had a big family. Everybody loves them. It's exactly what she needed. Sometimes people are dealing with things privately that they don't talk about publicly. If you hear the Lord telling you to do something for somebody or to reach out to them and make an offer to do it. Because I prophesy in the name of Jesus, you are in a season where your radical obedience is going to be the key that unlocks a door to radical abundance. Are you catching it? In this season, your radical obedience to the Lord will be the key that unlocks the door to explosive financial overflow. Now, the devil wants to steal your inheritance. He wants to steal your blessing, and he will mess with your head. He will introduce thoughts and questions and fears to make you hold back, overthink, and not do it. Last thing he wants you to do is put seed in the ground. Please catch it. The last thing he wants you to do is plant for a future harvest. The last thing he wants you to do is sow into somebody else and therefore unlock overflow to yourself. But if you hear the Lord, and God has a way of making sure that you know it's him talking to you, if you hear the Lord, don't hesitate. Don't ruminate. Go for it. Don't hesitate. Don't ruminate. Go for it. God is looking throughout the whole earth for people he can show himself mighty through. And when he finds somebody who is a real sower, he will give you seed. And you will never lack. You will never lack. You will never. I'm prophesying, when God knows that you are a sower, you will never, ever lack. Now, we're going to come back for part two of this on Friday, because I now have two people waiting on me. Oh my goodness. All right. So I got to go. We have it's actually a very key appointment. Pray for us, you guys. This is a good appointment. So pray for us, but I love you all very much. If the Lord leads you to sow into this, give honor where honor is due. put seed onto this word. Make sure you tell us that you're sowing into financial explosive financial overflow so I can help you by praying for you and lifting up your name to the Lord. So make sure you put a note on it, but obey. I'm not asking for sure. 100% not asking. It's for you, not me. But if the Lord tells you to, obey. All right, guys, I'll see you on Friday for part two. Meanwhile, I fully expect in Jesus' name to get a slew, just a never-ending, ongoing praise reports all week long from all of you. Amen? On that note, God bless you. This is your last chance to share. And I'll see you for Wednesday morning prayer call. God bless you.